we want to write the linear equation 2x plus 3y equals 6 in the slope-intercept form. So we're given an equation in standard form. We want to write it in slope-intercept form, or the form y equals mx plus b, which means we'll have to take this equation 2x plus 3y equals 6 and solve it for y. To do this, the first step is to move the x term to the right side of the equation. So we'll have to subtract 2x on both sides of the equation. This would be 0, we'd have 3y equals, I'm going to go ahead and put the x term first and the constant second to match slope-intercept form. So we'll have negative 2x plus 6. And now to solve for y, we'll divide everything by 3. So the equation in slope-intercept form would be y equals negative 2/3 x plus 6 divided by 3, which is 2. And now that it's in this form, we should be able to identify the slope and the y-intercept. So the slope of the line is going to be negative 2/3. Remember, the slope tells us the rise over the run, or the vertical change with respect to the horizontal change. So if it's a negative fraction, I like to put the negative sign up into the numerator, which tells me the vertical change would be down 2, and the horizontal change would be right 3 because of the positive 3. And then the y-intercept is going to be positive 2. We don't want to just put y equals 2, because that's an equation of a horizontal line. We can express this two ways. We can say the y-intercept equals 2, or we can list the coordinates of the y-intercept, which in this case would have the coordinates 0, comma 2. Now for the last part, they ask us for two points on the line and then also graph the line. Well, one of the points would be the y-intercept. Let's go ahead and list that. And then to determine the second point, let's go ahead and graph the line and then pick a point from the line. So we'll start by plotting the y-intercept of positive 2 here on the y-axis. And then since the slope is negative 2/3 from the y-intercept, we'll move down 2 units and right 3 units. And we move down 2 units because the rise, or the vertical change, was negative 2. And we move right 3 units because the run, or the horizontal change, was positive 3. And notice how the second point has the coordinates 3, 0. So we can go ahead and use that as our second point on the line. And now we can also graph the line through those two points. And it would look something like this. We'll take a look at a second example in the next video, when the y-intercept is fractional, which makes determining the coordinates of the second point a little more challenging. I hope you found this helpful.